Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about that is HDA, that is halogen derivatives of alkane, and now we are going to talk about that is haloarenes. So what are haloarenes and what are the classification of the haloarenes? Let me talk about them. So now, talking about the definition could be given as So according to the definition, we could say that when one or more hydrogen atom of the aromatic hydrocarbon like benzene are replaced or are substituted by that is the corresponding number of the halogen atoms, and that halogen atoms would be chlorine, bromine, iodine and etc. So if they are substituted by the corresponding number of halogen atoms, the compound formed is basically it is known as haloarene. And let me give you an example. Suppose if we have an aromatic compound commonly known as benzene, suppose. So this is the aromatic compound, basically benzene that I have mentioned over here, and benzene consists of basically 6 hydrogen atoms. So, and even all the hydrogen atoms could be could be replaced by the corresponding number of the halogen atoms. Suppose I am just concerned with that of replacing only one of the hydrogen atom with that of the halogen atom. So somewhere, suppose if I have converted this if I have replaced this hydrogen atom with that of a chlorine atom, so we could get basically an aromatic compound in which basically one hydrogen has been replaced by the corresponding, that is the corresponding number of the halogen atom, and this is what we have, and this is basically known as, in terms of the definition, it is known as haloarene. So this is what the first example that I was talking about. So actually the name of this product that we have got over here is basically known as chlorobenzene. So this is what we have over here, and not only one hydrogen atom but several hydrogen atoms could be easily replaced with the help of the halogen atoms, and that is what we have now concerned with, that there are also certain kind of classifications that we are going to talk about. So therefore the classification of haloarenes can be classified into basically 3 categories, and talking about the first one, that is that is monohalogen derivatives of arenes, or that is monohaloarenes. So what is the definition of this? It is very easy to write the definition of it, and very easy to understand also. That is, that is when one hydrogen atom of an aromatic hydrocarbon is replaced by one halogen atom, and that could be chlorine, bromine and iodine. So therefore the compound that is formed is basically known as monohalogen derivative of arene. So let me give you the example of this one, that is chlorobenzene, bromobenzene. These all are the examples of monohalogen derivative of arene, or basically known as monohaloarenes. So talking about the next classification is basically that is dihalogen derivatives of arene, or basically known as dihaloarenes. So what is the definition of it? Let us understand that also. And that is The compound formed by replacing or substituting two hydrogen atoms of the aromatic hydrocarbon by two halogen atoms is basically known as dihalogen derivatives of alkene. So even this kind of definition could be given to the dihalogen derivatives or any kind of aromatic hydrocarbon which is consisting of that is two halogen atoms. So this is what we have. So let me talk about the example, and that example can be classified into further things. So let me give you an example so that we could understand that how many dihalogen derivatives of arenes are being possible if we take benzene as the main hydrocarbon. So let us talk about that. Suppose if we have benzene as the main hydrocarbon, and what we have to do is we have to replace that is two hydrogen atoms with that of the two halogen atom. So suppose if we have that is one hydrogen over here and one hydrogen over here, and that is what the under who suppose substitution so as to get that is halogen atom to take place over the hydrogen atom that were been earlier present in it. So therefore suppose this is Cl and here also it is Cl. So therefore the two hydrogen atoms have been replaced with the help of this two chlorine atoms. Now this is a kind of an example of dihaloarene. But talking about the name or the IUPAC name of this kind of substance would be given as that is 1,2 dichloro, that is benzene. So talking about the another one, that is there is another possibility also, where we could get basically the substitution reaction where we could find that is the chlorine atom is present on this and over this. So now this is basically if we have to give the name of this one, so therefore even this is suppose if we have given the nomenclature to this one, then I have preferred to give the number to the chlorine atom in such a way that is whenever I find the next chlorine it should also get the least number. So therefore I have not given the name like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. I have to give the number like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 to the carbon atom. So this is the rule of IUPAC nomenclature, and that is what we have given the name to this one. And talking about this molecule that we have, that is this is the carbon number 1 that we have, 2, 3, 4. So therefore the according to the IUPAC nomenclature, the name of this one could be given as that is 1,4 dichlorobenzene. And talking about the another possibility that we could give is basically where we have that is substituted the hydrogen with the chlorine atom over here, and this hydrogen has been replaced by that of so therefore the name of this compound is basically, since I have to give the number it is not necessary that we have to give the number to only this carbon atom. We can give either number 1 to this carbon atom, 1, 2, 3. So therefore the name of this one would be given as 1,3 dichlorobenzene. So this is we have represented about the possible that is dihaloarenes, and talking about the further thing, that is this is what we have given the IUPAC nomenclature, but what if we have given that is we have to give the common name to this one. So if we observe that is this two chlorine atoms, they are basically they are attached or they are present in on the adjacent carbon atom, so therefore these are known as ortho disubstituents. Well, this is known as, because they are opposite to each other, so therefore it is known as parasubstituent. And since this kind of attachment where we could find that is they are attached in an alternate way, so therefore that is this is the carbon atom where the Cl has been attached, and leaving this carbon atom where no halogen atom has been attached over here, and the next substituent has been attached on the third carbon atom. So therefore this kind of system or this kind of that is compound, in terms of common name, we could give it as the name that is meta dichlorobenzene. So this is what we have got over here, that is talking finally about, this is basically ortho dichlorobenzene or ortho substituents. This is basically, I would write it over here as, now this is basically, it is known as meta disubstituent, that is meta dichlorobenzene, and this is basically para dichlorobenzene. So in terms of common name, we could give this as possible. So now, So this was basically the dihaloarenes, and now let us talk about the last one, or the last classification, and that is polyhalogen derivatives of arenes, or we could also call it as polyhaloarenes. So what is the definition of it? Let us talk about that also. Therefore, the definition could be given as, that is the compound formed by replacing two or more hydrogen atoms of an aromatic hydrocarbon by corresponding number of halogen atom is known as polyhalogen derivative of arene. So let me give you an example of this one. Suppose this is the benzene that we have, and we have to replace the hydrogen atoms and more than two. So suppose if we have bromine which is attached over here, and here also there is a bromine attached over here, and here also. So basically I am discussing about the trihaloarenes. So this is what we have over here, and talking about the IUPC name. So therefore the IUPC name could be given as, and it is very easy to give the IUPC name. So we have to give the IUPC name according to in such a manner that all the bromine atoms that have been attached on this aromatic compound or in this aromatic ring should get the least number. So therefore I could give the possible number as, that is 1, 2, 3 tri bromo benzene. So this is possible. And talking about the another possibility, or the another example for which we could discuss about the example of a poly halogen derivative of arene, is basically suppose we have chlorine that are being attached over here in this manner. Suppose again it is an example of that is a trihaloarene. Suppose if I include another one like this one, suppose here. So how can I give the name? So it is very easy to give, and let me discuss about that also, because this is an example that I am going to talk about. And since all the substituents are basically chlorine, so basically it is very easy for us to give the name or give the nomenclature for this one. So we have to start, or we have to start giving the number to that chlorine atom which from which basically there are more substituents that have been attached from that carbon atom. So if I give the number to this one, then either on this side or in the, or either on this side, there is no chlorine atom that has been attached over here. So therefore it is very much preferable if I give the number to this one as 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So that is possible. So therefore I could give the nomenclature for this one as 1, 2, 3, 5 tetra chloro benzene. So this is what we have. So this were the examples of that is the halogens. So now in this lecture we have discussed about what is halogens and what are the classification of halogens, and this is it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to what is halogens and what are the classification behind that, and thank you for watching this video, and I hope you will share this video with friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.